Oh my god, you want to be trans?
Yes, I do.
That takes such mental fortitude and force of will to want to be a woman.
Actually, I don't want to be a woman. I want to be a 1971 fire engine orange Pinto with white walled tires.
Autobots, transform and roll out!
Well, it looks like episode 7 is upon us already. More than meets the eye, and I think we can learn something from our Autobot friends. Never judge a book by its cover. With 862,250 results, transformation art is pretty popular on DA. Now, if you take the time to scroll through the results, you're going to see a wide variety of content related to transformation. But what exactly is it? I mean, how would you define it within this tag on DA itself? And one of the easier ways to clear this up, when you were younger and you watched Knight Rider, if you were in the majority, you wanted to be like David Hasselhoff, whereas the people in the transformation tag, they wanted to be Kit. After all, why simply sexually identify as an attack helicopter when you can actually be a fucking Apache? So let's delve deep into this. Let's take a look around the community and enjoy this fantastic artwork that surely awaits us. I'm sure it's going to be high quality and totally not balls to the wall insane. Get Tubed by Don Pretzi. So I had this dream half awake the other night where me and other people were turning into inflatable tubes of ourselves with these silly happy grins. And then we were launched through the air. It would bounce around. I thought I would quickly draw this. Anyone wanting to become a silly, huge, inflatable tube should apply within. A career in crowd surfing and being bounced on at venues is very important. That face says it all, doesn't it? That is some quality shit. I want to apply. This is how I want to live my life, as an inflatable, flailing tube man. Calm, cold spiked, X tofu bread X. I didn't think prolonged game time of Moon would really have an effect on me. This was actually randomized. I like the results. It's like Digimon hell. Look at the suffering on his fucking face. That looks like it's agonizing. There's nothing pleasant about this. Look at that fucking look. He wants to be shot. It's like putting down a lame horse. Kill me. Oh, Jesus Christ, just put the fucking bullet in my head. Oh, it hurts so much. Inflatamorphs, The Unique by JonesyCat79. You know, I've long thought to myself, the one piece of literature and art that I've always wanted to see were people transforming into inflatable pool toys. And my prayers have been answered. Just looking at this art is a dream come true. And oh my god, yes, there are included stories. If you want to know the story of this fictional universe, JonesyCat79 has got you covered. Light as a feather. Kelly felt her insides vanish as they were replaced with air, stretching her skin as far as it could hold. And her hands have already melded into fins. On her belly, now she could feel the fins sprouting on her jet black back. Well, here I go, she thought. How was this going to save their world? Two girls saw the orca toy and picked up Kelly's rubbery form. Would they take her to the supposedly hidden base under the lake? Well, she was about to find out. Please, for the love of God, Jonesy, you have to complete this masterpiece of fiction. I need to know. I have to fucking know if those little girls brought Kelly, the inflatable orca, to their hidden lake base to save the world from the threats that are out there. I'm not sure who the supervillain in this universe would be, but I want to see her conquer him with her inflated fury. Orca Girl, as I'm calling Kelly now, Orca Girl is the superhero that deviant art desperately needs. Now, Kelly's not the only one who likes to put a little bit of story into their artwork, such as Happy Accident by Altered Zangie, a Raptor TF comic from my buddy Shrapnel. Everything seems to be fine, just a guy out for a drive. Oh, looks like we had a little bit of an accident. I better pull over. I'm feeling a bit strange. Not sure where this mystery novel is headed. Hey, wait a minute. Is this that tetanus I've heard about? Boy, maybe I should have gotten vaccinated for that. I didn't realize it gave you giant orange claws. He sure, I'd be freaking out about that too a little bit. Well, holy shit. I've crapped myself in fear. My hands have turned into giant raptor claws, and I've defecated in my pants. He seems to be taking it really well. You know, if I were in this position, I don't know if I'd have a giant heart symbol above my head and a look of euphoria on my face as a 14-foot tail sprang out of my ass. Hey, this happens to everybody. You go for a drive, get a little scratch on your hand, crash your car on the side of the road, grow a 14-foot tail, couple of raptor claws for hands and feet, nothing to freak out about. I'd better go back to the apartment and show my buddy. Maybe he can help me. Oh, he just wants to pet me. And then everyone else. Yeah, true story. True story. That's how the first Digimon came about. It's just a dude got some tetanus on the side of the road, and they wrote a whole fucking children's show about it. And I know what you're thinking, and you're all in luck, because Altered Zangy has over 240 uploads. And what's that? Even better! Stopped uploading for a while for no reason. Sorry about that. I'm back at it now. Only 135 more pages to go, P. That is a total of nearly 400 pieces of amazing, story-driven artwork dealing with men turning into raptors. It's like a celebration. Happy fucking birthday. Growing Cube Collection by Hell Resident Infil 18. Warning. Cartoonishly deformed, cubed, and compressed girls. Body transformation morph. I bet you'd look so hot. Cubed and compressed is a decoration for my living room, along with my other items there. You patted your hand on the edge of the table in front of you, while staring right into Sonya's eyes with a grin. Oh yeah? And how exactly are you going to do that, you wise guy? Sonya, who was dressed in nothing but golden lingerie, talked back in annoyance, placing her hands nervously on her waist, while her left feet started tapping the floor. Well, here's how, you yelled, when with a sudden move, you suddenly pulled the large red curtain by your desk, revealing a large piece of machinery that looked like a trash compactor, but way more fancy. It's like my Minecraft fetish has come to life, and it's sitting in my living room in cubed form. I could build a whole house of hot hose out of that bitch. It's like sexual Legos. How can you not love this? There's even one with a little hat. It's just a little cube girl with a little fucking hat on her head, getting kicked out the window. I don't even know what the fuck is going on here. We're so past, I don't really understand it, but I appreciate the artistic vision of it. Commission for Palminio X, The Transformation, by Zobstance.
Oh, hey there, little kit. You wanna come ride on the horsey's back? I just wanna nibble on your face a little bit. Just come closer. Come closer to Mr. Horsey. I just want to eat your flesh a little bit. Don't you want to ride the pony, little boy? Come a little closer. Yeah. Yeah, rub that mustard on your face. Yeah, come over here. Everything's fine. Nothing bad's going to happen. I just want a little nibble.
What fucking nightmare fuel shit is this? You know, I'm noticing a little bit of a trend in some of the art. There's some dark fucking undertones. I don't know if that's intentional or not, but there's some really creepy shit kind of interspersed with the other transformation art. You've got, like, the inflatable people and the cubed people, but then you get into some stuff that's really just pure nightmare fuel. It's like a creepypasta come to life. I'm talking hellscape kind of shit. Let me show you what I'm talking about. Just take a look at some of these amazing pictures, and I want you to imagine dark carnival music playing in the background. Just imagine that music playing as this thing is walking around your fucking house. You can hear its footfalls, its giant kangaroo-assed footfalls, as this living snowman shambles its way up to your room with a butcher knife held in its mouth. It's pictures like this that make me think furries don't really know what they're asking for. Because this would be the reality. It's not the cute, fluffy anime yarn costume that you made. It's this shit. This is what's going to be looking you in the face as it mounts you in your darkest, deepest fucking nightmare. But it doesn't even end there. That's why I think they're maybe not aware of how fucking horrific this shit is. I'm gonna read you this description, then I want you to take a look at the picture and tell me if it matches. Les Femmes Fatales, page 3 of 5, by White Flame K. An orca whale transformation sequence done for the fantastic artist Griff, whose work inspires most of my visual art. His page can be found here. This comic explores the more erotic side of transformation artwork. Keyword there. Erotic. Take a look at the following and tell me if this gives you a boner or makes you want to call 911. If I saw this fucking thing crawling its way across the floor of my room at 2 a.m, I would jump out a fucking window. I would be screaming for the neighbors to call a priest to perform a goddamn exorcism. Just take a look at some of this artwork and just tell me this doesn't strike you as mentally fucking scarring. If you were to make a children's book out of this, you would give birth to a new generation of serial killers. Every piece of it is so remarkably twisted, and I just don't understand how they're unaware of that. Now, I will say, I do think some of them are slightly aware, such as Hyperjet, Female Into Car, TF Animation. A woman explores an empty garage and becomes the victim of a mysterious transformation machine in this fantasy horror animation short. This was produced as a result of Transformia promotion of 2011. And it has a YouTube link. That's right, this is a YouTube video. I'm gonna play some of this for you, because this guy totally gets it. Okay, perhaps I was a little too quick on the draw on that one. It's not so much they get it as they get off to it, at least judging from the voice acting. Sounds a bit like an early Newgrounds porno to me, just saying. But I don't want to leave you this evening with nightmares. Instead, I would prefer to get your noggin jogging by introducing you to a unsolved situation. I'm talking about the mystery of the missing maxi pad. It turns out a particular individual has vanished. All of their social media accounts are shut down. Their YouTube account, their Twitter account, their Facebook account, even their DeviantArt account all mysteriously have vanished from the internet. Even articles talking about this individual have been pulled down by the authors that wrote them. I'm talking about Pad Gardner.
So was there like an actual moment in your, say, childhood or adolescence where you realized you wanted to become a menstrual pad?
When I was 10 years old.
That's right. Pad Gardner, the man that wants to live as a pink disposable feminine pad. Where has he gone to? What has happened to good old Pad Gardner? About me. I am a guy that is becoming a pink disposable feminine pad. And later on, I will be pressed against a soft vulva for a woman's period. I'm looking for more open-minded friends who are comfortable about this fate for me. I have wanted to become a pad since I was 10 years old. My 2013 New Year's resolutions. Number 1. To get my legal first name changed to Pad. Number 2. To start preparing for life as a feminine pad. Number 3. To travel around the United States before becoming a pad. Number 4. To set a world record for having the largest pad collection. Number 5. To become a pink disposable feminine pad. And how was Pad's pad collection coming along before he disappeared?
How many pads do you have at home?
1,407 pads.
1,407 pads. That is dedication. Now, the bits and pieces of information I've been able to gather surrounding this mystery all come from archived screenshots. All of his accounts are gone, so we only have a handful of information to go on as to his whereabouts and the ultimate fate of the man that wanted to be a maxi pad. In fact, one of the last things I could find regarding him was this ravishly article, The Problem with Human Maxi Pad, Pad Gardner, in which we might have a possible lead on what happened to him. Not so surprisingly, Gardner has been on the receiving end of equal extremism. He claims he received threats from men's rights activists in which they demanded that Gardner stop using the men's restroom, or else. Gardner's Facebook page reports, "Today I went to my math class at the college, and upon leaving class I was being followed around by two guys. After leaving the college, they continued to follow me downtown as I walked. I realized I was being followed and hid inside a bathroom downtown. They came into the bathroom and jumped me. They said I didn't belong in the men's room. They hit me in the stomach and ran. I received an email a few hours ago from a men's rights activist telling me to stay out of the men's bathroom and to expect more violence if I continue to be referred to as a male. Well, you know what, you assholes? Can have your stupid gender. You know what? I'm a pad, and I'm damn proud not to be a part of your violent gender." Well, it appears as if Mr. Gardner, our friend the maxi pad, might have been beaten to death by men's rights activists for daring to use a urinal. Those goddamn MRAs are always beating up people who identify as feminine hygiene products. Now, I've looked into this as much as I can. I don't know what happened to this individual. Maybe he was reincarnated.
Buddhists believe that they're reincarnated until, like, they relieve their suffering and become more enlightened. Well, I believe being reincarnated constantly as a regular Pad.
Or perhaps he's dead in a gutter. Ultimately, though, the truth of his fate is in your hands. Can you track down Mr. Gardner? Can you find out what happened to the living MaxiPad? Can you solve this mystery?
Do you consider yourself a Pad right now?
On the inside, yes.